Today, I want to share with you some of the healthy habits that I'm bringing to this 2024. Just saying, 2024 sounds crazy to me because last year went by super quick, and I have the feeling that this year is also going to go by so quick too. Last year was so really, I don't know how to like put it in words, to be honest with you, but it was a very, very emotional year. Anyway, so now that I am reflecting on my year, yes, it was heavy, but at the same time, I feel so blessed that I was able to grow personally and to reflect in those emotions that I was feeling before, you know what I mean? Like, facing like those traumas, trap energy, you know, like this week I was doing a reflection and I was really like truly seeing outside like that 2023, and it really made me realize how much I've been growing, how much I grow as a person, how much healing it has happened, including everything around me, the people around me as well. Talking, and let's dive in to my 2024 habits that I'm breaking this year. I wrote them down, don't want to forget them. So my habit number one that I'm bringing this 2024 is continue with my healing journey, continue with my mental health healing, and focusing on things that help me grow personally and mentally and just nourish my overall body, mind, and soul. That's my goal or my habit for this 2024, to focus in my mental health, to for me at least means that just be around people, my loved ones, be more connected with them, be more present in moments when I am around them, and create that habit to call my family or at least once a week and do a FaceTime with them, just kind of like I can see them. Just seeing them, it's a little bit different than only like being on the phone whenever possible. So that's that. One of the things that I've been practicing since last year, and I'm bringing to this 2024, is keep myself hydrated. Okay, keep yourself hydrated. It's very important for many reasons. Just keep drinking water when waking up before anything else, like before coffee. I used to drink my cup of coffee and then next is my water, which I was not doing right. I bought this mug, which I mentioned it on Instagram previously, and I carry this mug everywhere. So there is that. Just keep myself hydrated, especially when waking up. I try to have one glass of water, one cup of water. Habit number four that I'm bringing to this 2024, which I started last year, is to keep moving my body, keep exercising at least 3 times a week. If I can do more, then do more. I love running, so I've been focusing so much in like doing my running. I honestly stopped doing it because rain season started, so I didn't have a treadmill. I have to stop running, but I love to run. I love to be outside. Winter is here, so I try to not go out too late And if it gets too dark outside, I try not to do that because I don't feel safe in a way. Other habit is to keep doing this, which I last year I tried to do it and I just fell out of the train. To keep a journaling and do a meditation practice every day for at least 10 minutes, you know. Before I used to do it for like 30 minutes, but I gotta be realistic and sometimes I cannot do it for like 30 minutes, so 10 minutes it's okay. So that's one of the habits that I'm bringing to this 2020, mindful practice or practice something like to help me. Really journaling, I call it a trash can because I empty all my thoughts. If I do it at nighttime, I empty all my, you know, things that were bothering me during the day or like things that I accomplished or my feelings or my emotions, whatever the case might be, but I do it at nighttime and pretty much I've been consistent. The second, it is to, I don't know what number this is, but limit my screen time, especially at nighttime. I'm trying to cut out the hours that I'm on my phone. If I'm gonna be posting videos for like Instagram or for TikTok or for YouTube or whatever, I try to do it before 10:30 at the latest by 11. So I try to be off my phone by that time and no more screen time. I'm trying to be more mindful in when I wake up, not to really touch my phone or see the screen at least 50 minutes. I'm starting with 50 minutes and I'm gonna see if I can do it more after. But for me to create a habit is to first start with a baby step and then you can jump to the next step, you know, like a bigger step, in other words. So there is that. And then so limit my screen time. Things that I've been also practicing a lot because I know I was not good doing this. I was sleeping with like 3 pillows behind me and my back and my neck were killing me. Like, I'm not kidding when I tell you, I used to wake up with really bad headaches. So now I'm only sleeping with one pillow and trying to position myself in a way of when I'm laying in bed in a way that will make me feel like better when I wake up. And honestly, has not been easy, to be honest with you, because I am so used to sleep on my side or sleeping with like 3 pillows. And now I gotta say that it's been like this 4 days already that I'm practicing how to sleep without those 3 pillows, and it's been feeling better. It's been feeling better on my back, better with my head. I don't wake up with headaches no more. And also practice my sleep routine, which that takes me to my vitamins that I'm gonna, this year my mom got me this pill box container because I was not doing good with my pills. So I'd rather have this pill container, which I refill every Sunday, and right, because that helps me to be consistent with it. And so I start taking magnesium in the afternoons and then before I go to sleep. So far that has been helping me to go to sleep. Honestly, I was not really getting a good sleep, good nighttime sleep. I was feeling super anxious during the night, and that's one of the things that I want to work this year in, how to like feel my emotions and feel when I feel anxious and really work in that trap, like energy or emotions that I have. Because really what I am learning is that when you feel anxious, it's really a trap energy inside you that can trigger something else. It might be from being anxious all the time. If you don't really like work with the cause of your anxiety, can lead you to depression and can lead you to some other physical like pains and all that. So I don't want to get to that point. So I'm really working with like my anxiety that I've been experiencing lately, which I am doing like more like as I say, journaling, meditating, trying to work with the things that I actually like and be very consistent 4